Right, welcome back to the final part of the cylinder head assembly. So, where I left it last night, yesterday, I was going to do all of the injectors and all the glow plugs on camera, but light started fading and it wasn't that great. The quality wouldn't have been good at all. So what I decided to do was fit the first four injectors and the first four glow plugs, and I saved the very last so I could come out here this morning, a fresh day, do the final one, put the final pulleys on, one for the diesel timing belt, diesel pump, and then the other one for the timing belt. These are the pulleys here, we've got both of them, the diesel pump and the timing pulley. I've already gone ahead and put that water housing, the water 90 bend, that bit of pipe, that's already been put on. That is where the diesel pump tensioner goes. That's the nut for the alternator bracket. That's all been cleaned out. This is only just resting on here at the moment, just to keep it all protected. This has been set up TDC, using the old bar, so we set that up TDC. Happy days. Sealants on there, that's all looking good, so I don't have to worry about any of that at the moment. The top end, so we're just going to put these injectors in first. So you got that bit there, the injector. Okay, so cleaning your injectors. I cleaned about this much. Well, I've cleaned the injector, all the worst of the dirt off. I mean, this is the final, the fifth injector. So we've got the sensor on it as well. And this little union with the nipples on it, and a couple of washers. I've taken that off, cleaned it. Reason why I took that off is because it's easier to get in there with the Allen key, because it was fouling on the nut. On that bolt, sorry. So I didn't clean this at all. I haven't touched that because they're very fine little holes and you don't want to block them up at all. So what I did do, I cleaned the little face here where the copper washer goes, and then I put a little bit of copper grease on there. Well, you can barely see, but there's this tiniest bit of copper grease on there, and that's just to hold the washer on there while I insert it into the hole. Again, if you're going to be putting your injectors and glow plugs in first, what you need to remember is that they stick out at the bottom. They will protrude. Along with, once you put the cam on, the valves are going to be open. So we've got that little bit in there. They sit like that. I've gone ahead, wrote down the torque setting for the injector brackets, and they are 23 newtons. So we've got a little... This needs to be set up to 23. Oh, did I lock it? Did I? There we go, that's 23. This is the quarter inch. My quarter inch torque. So I've now got a quarter inch, 3/8 and 1/2. Happy days. So let's there we go. So that's 23. And then for the glow plug, 15. I wrote them down on the final ones so I could always, so I wouldn't forget, basically. So we've got 15 for the glow plugs, 23 for the injectors. Let's just adjust this quickly. That's 15. That's the glow plug and injector, both torqued up. I'm going to put that back on. There we go. Happy days. Right. Cylinder head is now ready to be fitted. I could, if I want, I could install the exhaust manifold and the intake manifold. I could do that now, put these gaskets on. It would make my life easier doing it all on the workbench. However, it would make my life a lot harder because I'm doing this job on my own. And if I had the exhaust manifold and the intake manifold on the back, along with the weight of the cylinder head, I don't think I'm going to be able to lift it up and be able to put it over and into the engine, doing it carefully and gently. Because the van is still jacked up, so obviously I've got to lift it up over, and too much of a pain. You know, I can just take my time with it, so I'm going to do it as it is, just put the cylinder head on and then install the manifolds and time it all up, and yeah, we'll get all of that done when it's on the head. Right, so what we'll do is I'll put these on now loosely. These need to be loose because when we actually go to time it up, this needs to be able to spin around when we put the tensioner on, once we've got the diesel pump timed up. And then once we've got it all timed up and the belt's on there, we can nip this up. So we'll leave it loose for now. And the same again for the timing belt. That needs to be loose to start off with until we get it tensioned up. So there we go. Happy days. Right, I'm going to leave it here now and finish off that, because I think that's the assembly head rebuilt. Not a lot more I can do to that now. I mean, it's pretty much rebuilt. I've now got a few things to do, so that'll be in next time's video. I want to check the bore again, the block again. Double check all the threads where the head bolt's going to go through. I have cleaned them out already, but I want to do another clean. Just double check everything. I'm going to get a couple of old head bolts. I'm going to cut the head off, and then we'll put some slots in it so we can use those as, you know, location dowels kind of thing, location pins. You'll see all of that coming up in the next video. So yeah, I'm going to crack on with that, and you can see that next time. So hopefully you've been enjoying these little videos, these little uploads, and I'll keep them coming for the foreseeable future. So thanks for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. And take care, stay safe, God bless.